My name's Sal Gonzalez. I'm a singer-songwriter out of Nashville, Tennessee. But I still wish that I had gone with him. Or maybe even took his place. Oh, but destiny didn't lead me that way. And I'm also a retired Lance Corporal in the United States Marine Corps. One day I got a phone call from Team Trophy Quest to get an opportunity to come out and fish with John and a bunch of the sponsors. And I said, yeah.
See y'all later. We're leaving Nashville going fishing.
Yeah, I'm Lynn Parker, Senior Vice President of Purchasing for the TVC Retail Group. Service Central, which is the service brand of the TVC Retail Group, has teamed up with Johnny Gray. Johnny is the driver of our Service Central Top Fuel Funny Car, along with his son Shane Gray, who drives the Service Central Pro Stock car in the NHRA Professional Series.
At the Gator Nationals, we were talking, and Lynn started talking to me about Trophy Quest doing a show. He told me about Sal, and I thought it would be a great honor to have Sal and his father on our houseboat on Del Hollow, Kentucky to go fishing and try to show him some kind of appreciation for what him and people like him do for us.
You know what, Sal?
You know, the weather was not too cooperative today, but we had a good day on the lake. Everybody had a lot of fun. Fished with Lynn and got to catch fish, and Lynn didn't, so that's always good, you know. Got to take Axel, my dog, out and have some fun with him. He loves to fish, so all in all, the day was good.
Johnny was very gracious to offer his houseboat and his facility and come out here and do the filming of this particular segment with Sal. And oh my gosh, he's got it on there. I tell you, he set the hook on that one. May not drive a funny car very good, but he can sure bring in those smallmouth. Well, that's a good one. There you go. That's a great fish. Good job.
Don't wait too long.
I had CEO Orland Wolford with me this week, which is the CEO of our title sponsor, Service Central.
I hadn't been fishing for years, freshwater fishing. I used to do it as a kid in farm ponds, and it looked like a real opportunity to come up here, not only to fish, but to spend some time with one of our American heroes. And it was really nice to have some time to spend with Sal here, get a chance to meet him, know him. We got back in those coves. It was so quiet that the only you could hear was the sound of your bait hitting the water. And unfortunately, there was no sounds of any fish hitting your bait after they hit the water. But to sit there and listen to Sal talk about how much this meant to him, you know, how insignificant the fishing was, but just being out on the lake and having some time to be away and put all things behind them and have a good time.
You know what? It doesn't matter if we catch anything or not. I'm just having a good time sitting out here with you guys.
It was a great time.
Fishing the whole time, but I was in class one day on September 11th, 2001, and we saw the towers fall. And it was about that time that we all just kind of looked at each other and we're like, all right, boys, we're getting ready to go to war. When I graduated in 2003, I enlisted into the Marine Corps. A year later, I was in Iraq. October 31st, 2004, I was a machine gunner on a Humvee for a weapons platoon in our Ramadi, Iraq. We were escorting some supplies over to some other Marines. And on the way back, we got hit with a pretty big improvised explosive device. The bomb went through our rear left passenger door and when it went through, it hit three of us. There was Kenny, myself, and a gentleman by the name of Matt Lynch. My lieutenant, Matt, didn't make it through the explosion. It wasn't until I tried to get up and I looked down at my leg that I noticed that, you know, something was wrong. I ended up falling into a coma, and I woke up a week later in Bethesda, Maryland. They had to amputate, and I was discharged from the Marine Corps. December 27, 2005, as a retired Lance Corporal.
Teddy was a wild one when he was a young man. Spent his nights in fierce fights, alcohol and heavy hands.
And I tell you, that night we were on the boat and he had that guitar, and I hadn't even heard Sal sing up to that point. And as soon as he opened his mouth, it was unbelievable. I mean, everybody on that boat was in awe.
Said I was tumbling when I saw the light. Until I woke up, I thought I had died. And no one should have walked away that night. And now it's something that I can't explain. That pulled me from them flames. I know that I didn't get to meet all. But I caught a glimpse of Jesus.
Orland Wolford came over to me and said, you know what, we need Sal to help us open up, you know, our annual conference that we have coming up in Orlando in May. And it was just a no-brainer. And it said, you know, of course we've got to do that.
I guess when you shot machine guns for a living, it's life gets a little boring after that. So I moved to Nashville to work on music. My name was brought to the attention of some guys named Scotty Huff and Robert Reynolds. They have an organization that's called Operation Sound Off that's dedicated to helping veterans who have forestalled their musical dreams to serve their country.
We've been able to do an awful lot in the music industry. We've toured the world. We've recorded in great facilities like this. We've played with lots of wonderful musicians and artists, and we're able to do that because of the men and women that are willing to put their lives on the line to provide us the freedom to do this. And we know that there's lots of them that would love to do what we get to do every day. We kind of wanted to return the favor and give them some of those opportunities too.
Scotty and I really, you know, it was like an epiphany. We realized, wow, there has to be a percentage of men and women who are currently serving or have served and are just now out in back into civilian life and have given and often paid a great price for the freedom that we all enjoy. But I bet there's some musical men and women. These are people that put their guitar down to pick up some kind of a skill in the military that is part of these two conflicts, these two wars. I thought, oh, they put a guitar down and pick up a gun and defend this dream of mine. Wow. So, you know, we want the guitar back in their hand when it's time and when they're ready, and we want to provide opportunity that feels very, very much like it's theirs to have, and we just need to make certain that they get it. We love that we can help them get their songs finished from the songwriting process, get their songs recorded at a degree and a level that's far greater than the average opportunities they would find.
Sal's the kind of guy you want to meet for not only for this type of project, but just in general because of his talent and his voice when he sings and his charisma and his songwriting ability. And he is really, he's the real deal.
I sat down and played for him and they were just kind of blown away.
We didn't expect to meet that level of talent, at least not right off the bat.
Yeah, but first artist.
The first guy we meet is Sal Gonzalez. He has been wounded in battle. He has a prosthetic leg. His left leg had to be removed, but he carries it well. He comes back from Iraq, and he comes to Nashville to chase his dream for songwriting and ends up writing this incredible song called Heroes, which will tear your heart out because it's not just some contrived patriotic song that someone created to you know, to get a tear in your eye. He wrote this from an autobiographical standpoint, and it's the real deal.
Yeah.
There's no way you can call me a hero after my sacrifice is minimal compared to the price that Matt Lynch paid, or the 10 guys that we lost in Ramadi in 2004, the price that they've paid. Put pen to paper. And I just really started, I wrote this song called Heroes, and it just flew out of me. It was probably the fastest I've ever written a song.
Well, his father walked up to him, and he held him in his arms, and they both broke down and cried. As he held that purple heart, he said, Danny had a daughter that he'll never get to see, 'cause he proudly gave his life at the age of 23. And they gave his mom a medal just the other day for saving all our lives when he jumped on that grenade. So I told me to not sound grateful, 'cause the good Lord knows I am, for sparing me my life on the day he took my friend. But I still wish that I had gone with him, or maybe even took his place. Oh, but destiny didn't lead me that way. I'm not trying to say you're wrong, but heroes ain't the ones that make it home.
Sal is magic to me. He is a beautiful human being. It comes from, I see it now, meeting his dad, just amazing people. He's a gift, and I hope the world gets to hear his music, because he deserves it, and we would be blessed to hear it.
I wish that I had gone with, or maybe even took his place.
He sings it not only from his heart, from his soul. And when he says the words that he would gladly have gone with his commander, it's true. And when I hear that, it's a little gun-wrenching for me, but I know it, that he means it very, 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 very so. But we're all thankful that he's here.
You know, when most kids grow up, their father is their hero. But you know, one thing I've noticed with everything that's went on with Sal is Sal Jr. has become the hero of his father. What an honor.
He's a very, very talented young man, and it's God give him. I had nothing to do with it. I may have started him on the road, but when he was in line for talent, God gave him a good share. I think that's one of the reasons he was spared, that God has a plan for him, and his plan is to sing and not let us all forget all the men and women who have sacrificed everything for us.
He gave a lot, so we can do what we do here. Some gave all, so we can do what we do here. And just to be able to have a person of his stature come fish with me, enjoy my houseboat, what I've got, and everything. It's just a great honor to have him here.
He understands that he knows that what he has done gives us the freedom to do what we do, but he never has to say it, and he doesn't say it. It's not about Sal. That's what makes him such a special person.
You know, the one thing that I'd like to say about the entire TBC retail team, all of our over 10,000 associates, they love to do things to help. There are a lot of good people that are out for a lot of good causes. And you know, I'm a firm believer that you reap what you sow. I think a large part of the success that we've had at TBC Retail is that we reach out. In addition to all these charities we've done and supported, the one thing that we should never know, that if it weren't for people out there fighting for our freedom every day, making sacrifices that you and I can't even imagine, none of this would be possible.